At the Congress, the impact of the radicals had been out of all proportion to their numbers. The weekly journal Argumenti e Facti, which sells over 30 million, ran a poll to determine the best deputy. Top choice was Sakharov. Yeltsin was second, and Gorbachev, who had given them their chance, came only 17th.
But despite all this, Gorbachev was extremely pleased. He said, at last, we have a normal political structure where people can argue and work together instead of throwing knives at each other. I guess you could call that a moment of political triumph for him.
The most important thing was not the decisions made at the Congress, but the fact that it actually happened that mattered. Its process. It was what happened during the session. Everyone in the entire country saw who their rulers were, how it was done, and what sort of people do it. Political awareness grew more in those 3 weeks than it had in 50 years. People got an inside look at the whole complicated machinery, and that determined many of the events that followed.
The Congress unleashed a new rebelliousness. Within weeks, Soviet miners joined the revolution from below.
I would talk to the miners about Congress. It was sort of a political lecture. Not all miners were fond of reading, and there was a lot of literature available. So I would take that material and I would read between the lines for them.
The miners had real grievances. One man a day died in the Soviet pits. For years, the miners wanted to improve safety standards, and they wanted more money. So what was it in 1989 that brought the Siberian miners out on strike?
Embarrassingly enough, it was the lack of soap. Our people are used to shortages, but for miners, soap was essential.
That's just hearsay. Yes, soap was one of their demands, but the miners faced much bigger problems.
Saluted by Lenin, the workers rose against the workers' state. Town by town, region by region, miners joined the Siberian vanguard.
We decided to go to Victory Square at 2 in the afternoon. The square in Prokopyevsk. We came in our work clothes to show off our pride and our strength.
Picture the square in the summer. It was July, very hot, about 86 degrees. The heat was very strong. The miners were in their overalls, all sweaty, dirty, in their helmets and rubber boots. 20,000 miners standing there, their eyes flaming.
Так и шах-то коксово, точно такая же колбаса была.